So this is the inferior surface of the liver or visceral surface of the liver. From left to right, the visceral surface presents the following impressions. At first, here in between the caudate lobe and the left lobe, there is an impression for the esophagus. Then this area here, this area is the impression for the stomach. This is called the gastric impression. Here, this is the fissure for ligamentum teres. This is the quadrate lobe. Here, this is the porta hepatis, and this is the caudate lobe. So in the caudate lobe, there is two processes. One, number one, this one here, this is the papillary process. And number two, this here, this area here, it looks like a tail. So this is called caudate process. And that is why the whole lobe is called the caudate lobe. Again, we have the fossa for the gallbladder here. We can appreciate this is the gallbladder, and it has some greenish discoloration due to bile. Again, we have the impression for the duodenum. Here, duodenal impression. For the second part of the duodenum, here it comes with the relation of the liver. Here we have the colic impression just beside the duodenal impression, colic impression. And this large area here, this is the renal impression for the right kidney and part of right suprarenal gland. So we can see there is a large area for the right kidney forming the renal impression. And here we have a pouch called hepatorenal pouch of Morrison. So what is hepatorenal pouch of Morrison? We know the kidney is covered with peritoneum from the front, and liver is also covered with peritoneum from the front. So by this arrangement, there is a peritoneal fold. There is a reflection of peritoneum which passes from the right side of the liver to the anterior surface of the right kidney here and forms a recess here. Here lies the kidney, this is the liver. So the peritoneum passes from the liver and reflects above the kidney. So this is called the hepatorenal pouch of Morrison. What is the clinical importance of this pouch? It is the most dependent part of the peritoneal cavity in the upper abdomen during supine position. So after an surgery at the abdomen, the fluid, that is blood, pus or bile, tends to collect here in this pouch. And sometimes fluid collects in a hepatorenal pouch following a surgical removal of the gallbladder. Therefore, as a routine, after operation of gallbladder, a drainage tube is inserted in the hepatorenal pouch and kept for a few days till no fluid is aspirated. So this is the clinical importance of hepatorenal pouch. Now we are going to take a look at the porta hepatis. So as you can see, this is the left lobe, this is the right lobe, and this is the porta hepatis of the liver. So again, it is a transverse non-peritoneal, this is a transverse non-peritoneal fissure and acts as a gateway of the liver. So what are the boundaries of the porta hepatis? If we place the liver in an anatomical position like this, then the quadrate lobe comes in front of the porta hepatis. So in front there is quadrate lobe, behind there is caudate process. This is the caudate process. Again, in the left, the fissures for ligamentum teres hepatis and ligamentum venosum, and in the right, the neck of the gallbladder here. So this area in between these four structures is the porta hepatis. Structures entering to the liver through this porta hepatis. The structures entering are the right and left branches of the hepatic artery, the right and left division of the portal vein, and hepatic plexus of nerves. Right and left branches of hepatic artery, hepatic right and left branches of the portal vein and hepatic nerves. Please be cautious not to call the portal vein hepatic vein, because hepatic vein are completely intrahepatic. So structure entering in the liver through porta hepatis are hepatic artery, portal vein and hepatic nerves. What are the structures which exits through the porta? They are right and left hepatic duct and lymphatics. Now relation from before backwards, the porta hepatis is related with right and left hepatic ducts from before backwards. Right and left hepatic ducts, right and left branches of the hepatic artery and right and left divisions of the portal vein. These are the relation. Again, I am going through the structures entering and exiting through the porta. Number one, entering. Entering structures are right and left branches of the hepatic artery, right and left divisions of the portal vein, hepatic plexus of nerve. Structure exiting or leaving through this porta are right and left hepatic ducts and lymphatics. So why the porta hepatis is not a true gateway? Because the porta hepatis gives passage to all the structures except the hepatic veins. Remember, hepatic veins doesn't pass through the porta at any cost. You have to remember this, hepatic veins doesn't pass through the porta. The portal veins pass through it. Hepatic veins doesn't pass through the porta. They directly drain into the inferior vena cava inside the liver. Here you can see the hepatic veins draining inside the inferior vena cava. So you must
remember this. Now I am going to speak about some histological structure of the liver. But as we know that this is a visceral demonstration, so we cannot go into details. But histologically, the liver presents groups of three cell clusters, namely hepatic lobules and portal acinus. So I recommend you go through any recognized textbook to learn about these hepatic lobules and portal acinus. That is because they are very much important for both your written and viva examination.
Now the nutrition of the liver. The liver gets nutrition from two sources. Number one, the portal vein, and number two, the hepatic arteries. In spite of having a less oxygenated blood, the majority of blood supplied into the liver comes from the portal vein. That is 66 to 75%. 66 to 75% of blood supplying in the liver comes from the portal vein, and 33 to 25% of the blood coming in the liver are supplied from the hepatic arteries. So now there may be some intrahepatic or extrahepatic anomalies to cause the intrahepatic hypertension. Number one among them is the cirrhosis of liver. So when the cirrhosis of liver occurs, then the hepatic blood pressure increases and thus causes a lot of trouble. Cirrhosis means fibrosis and scarring of the liver. So this is about the clinical and the blood supply of the liver in very short amount of time. And I recommend you go through all the textbook and the suggestions given by your teachers, respected teachers, to clarify any confusions. And if you have, after this demonstration, if you have any confusion regarding this show, then you may comment on the comment section below. And for the supply of viscera and other supports, we would like to express our heartfelt gratitude to the anatomy department of Sir Solihull Medical College and Whitford Hospital. And I do urge upon you to please like, comment and subscribe to our channel, and go visit our Facebook page. And stay blessed. Peace.